we're sort of in the second half of the SNL season.
Whoo, you're telling me, yeah. Bud.
You had a very busy, one of the most busy schedules the first half of the year that I'd ever seen.
I think it was like, yeah, it was the election, so they were like, let's pump these out.
Yeah, they pumped them out, and you guys got through it, and you did a great job. Fantastic work. Do you have, personally, do you have a favorite sketch of the year that you were involved with that you helped write?
I really did love our Halloween sketch. It was like the girls' Halloween.
It was fantastic.
Thank you so much.
It was sort of, for those who missed it, it sort of went from...
Thank you for the smatter, y'all. It really does mean a lot.
We flashed the smatter light. but it sort of showed girls getting ready for their Halloween night out
That's right.
Kept flashing forward to how badly it goes.
Yeah, and we were dressed as, like, cats and mice, and then it would cut to us just, like, melted whiskers, like,
Did you ever have any real-life Halloween meltdowns?
Yes, it's fully based on, like, a Halloween that I experienced in college where I was, like, dressed as a leopard, and I thought I was very cute. And I was just, like, feeling myself so hard, and I went to, like, a theater department party, as you do. And I, like, went there, drank a little bit, which I couldn't handle at all. And then I kissed, like, one boy in the theater department and then immediately went back to my dorm, called my high school boyfriend, and was like, I'm sorry! Like, couldn't handle it. Whiskers, like, pouring down my face.
Sad leopard.
Full sad leopard.
Yeah. And so you're not really a big drinker.
No, not at all. I would call myself a goody two-shoes.
A goody two-shoes.
Yes.
For those who don't know, one of the greatest nights of the year for an SNL staff member is what's called the writer's party. It's the last Thursday of the season.
Yeah.
And the writers and the cast go out, and there's no guests.
Yes.
And it's just a full-on boozer.
And it is, I would say, like, you take all the anxiety and, like, stress and power from the season, and you pour it into one night of drinking alcohol.
Yeah.
And, I mean, this most recent one that we've had at the end of last season, I would say it almost destroyed me as a human woman. Okay. Like,
because you drank too much.
I drank so much that I blacked out.
Okay.
Okay. Yes! I know! And... I mean, I didn't even know how I got home. I had to, like, drunk detective piece everything together the next morning. So I put together that I...
Where did you wake up?
I woke up in the hallway of my building on the floor, which is very humbling, yeah. You know? I may look like a painted lady right now, but I also sometimes sleep on the hallway floor. And so, yeah, like, I woke up on the... And the only reason I woke up was because I was hit by a newspaper that was being delivered to my neighbor's door. So, like, a woman came out of the elevator and just threw a newspaper down. And I was like, whoa! And so I woke up, and then I couldn't find a key, so I went down to my doorman, got a key, went into my apartment, and then I realized, like, oh, I don't have a purse. I don't have my phone or wallet or anything. So then I went to work, like, immediately, just an ill woman. I puked a little at work. At Saturday Night Live! And very humiliating, you know?
Yeah.
But then, like, 2 days later, basically, a doorman was like, does this purse belong to you? Because I had left it on some random floor. I guess when I got home, I just pushed any button in the elevator, went up there, and then just was like, I'll sleep in this hallway. And then when I was awoken by the paper, I just left my belongings there. And was like, okay, I know where to go. Doorman, get me inside. You know, like, full drunk monster.
Oh, we have a photo of you from this party.
Oh, yeah.
I've got to be honest. I think you look fine.
Yes.
Look at you right there in the middle. That...
Truly, truly that... very sad.
That looks like a photo Keith Morrison shows on Dateline. Like, and that was the last we ever saw.
I know. The deadness in my eyes and the Irish on my face is so full throttle. It's very rough.